Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of MSI Procast. Today I wanted to take time to talk about Intel Optane. Intel Optane is a new technology by Intel and sizes up quite impressively in performance. But how does it work? How to use it? And how much faster does it really get? Let's take a look. First of all, let's clarify a few things about Intel Optane technology. To begin with, what is it? Intel Optane complements our existing memory and storage solutions, such as your SSD drives, your hard drives, and your RAM. Underneath, Intel Optane drives use something called 3D Crosspoint, which makes it extremely fast and act like a super cache, speeding up access to essential data needed by your processor. Now you're probably thinking, is this another RAM memory or faster storage? Well, it's sort of both. Besides being a 3D crosspoint memory media, Intel Optane modules combine both Intel memory and story controller, as well as other building blocks such as Intel Interconnect IP and some Intel software. So together, these building blocks significantly decrease latency and accelerate your systems for workloads that demand large capacity and fast storage. With Intel Optane being both memory and storage, how much faster would you expect your system to be? According to the Intel website and our own research, performance is measured as following. Combining a classic hard drive with Intel Optane yields roughly the same performance as a standalone SSD drive. Extremely interesting. This bridges the gap between both options and makes it appealing for anyone still using hard disks as daily storage solutions. The question is now, what do you need to use Intel Optane on your PC? So let's take the example of a typical mainstream build with a Z270 motherboard and a Core i7-7700 CPU. To use Intel Optane, you'll need at least a 7th generation Core i-series processor. This means at a minimum, you must have a Kaby Lake processor in your computer. So for this example, it'd be no problem at all. Your system would be Intel Optane ready. Okay, this is all beautiful and great, but how to set it up? Once you sort out the prerequisites for Intel Optane to work in your system, all you need to do is install the Intel Optane module on your motherboard's M.2 slot. The next step is a little tricky as it takes almost 16 steps to set up Intel Optane in the BIOS. But luckily, with MSI motherboards, you can simply do that in a single step via the Optane Genie option. Finally, install Windows drivers and that's it. I'll show you in a second how to do it. It's easy. Final question, do I need to combine Intel Optane with a hard disk drive, an SSD, or both? We did some tests and yes, we could see that the Intel Optane combined with a hard drive almost gets the same speed as a standalone SSD. Now, if you account for all the extra costs of getting an Intel Optane drive, it's definitely worth noting all the options you can choose from. The classic SSD plus hard disk drive, SSD with Intel Optane and no hard drive, a hard disk drive with Intel Optane, or the ultimate SSD with Intel Optane plus extra hard disks for storage. No matter what, we always suggest Intel Optane to increase storage speed for whatever storage layout you plan to use. All right, let's take a look at an actual setup of an Intel Optane drive. As mentioned earlier, all you really need to do is to take your Intel Optane drive and connect it to one of your available M.2 slots. Here we're using an MSI Z270 Tomahawk OPT Boost motherboard. As you can see, it has two M.2 slots. You can pick any of them for your Intel Optane drive, however, we recommend the first slot. So for this example, we're using the Intel Optane plus hard disk drive combo to get the most out of it. Once this is done, we reboot our system and head into the BIOS by repeatedly pressing the delete key. In the BIOS, configuring Intel Optane is super easy. Navigate to the Optane Genie option and simply turn it on. All done, press F10 to save your new BIOS settings and reboot into the operating system. If you don't see the Optane Genie option, make sure to update your BIOS to the latest version to enable support. Once in Windows, we must install the Intel Optane drivers. Here again, nothing complicated. Just install the Intel Optane drivers, reboot your PC, and you are done. One more thing, if you're looking for an Intel Optane ready motherboard, you might want to check out one of the following three boards we just announced. The Z270 Tomahawk OPT Boost, the B250M Bazooka OPT Boost, and the B250M Pro OPT Boost all support Intel Optane out of the box with the same one-click Optane Genie option in the BIOS. Check out MSI.com for more info. So this concludes our Intel Optane journey. I hope this video was helpful in some way and enlightened you to some of the benefits of Intel Optane technology on MSI motherboards. Please use the comments below to share your questions. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. If you didn't, let us know why. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.